Hollywood. You know, what better map than Hollywood to kick off the California Cup?
Exactly. This is the California Cup. So we're going to be in our home stage of Hollywood. And we saw earlier today UCI. They were able to get the full hold up against UCSD. UCLA, though, they're going to be starting off on the defensive end here. And it looks like they're not going to go for anything like the Junkrat or the Soldier 76. They're going to go with Raxa on the Hanzo, along with Seven on the Doomfist. So Doomfist we don't see as much often, but this is quite an interesting pick, especially here on the defense. But take a look at Cal's offense coming out from them. They are represented by Gulag, Jay, Kaido, Alter, Harukaze, Tribal, and Banana Bread. It looks like they're going to go for a really divey composition. They've got the Sombra, but she's spotted out by the Sonic Arrow.
Yeah, the Sombra Doomfist comp, though, is very strong in the sense that once you get onto the back line, there's so many one-shots. You know, the hack, it takes away so much that you can do it in, as a reaction, right? So you're really looking to see the Sombra get to the back line, get a hack off. Looks like he stops it early.
Yeah, he's going to go ahead and put pressure onto the point right now. Someone's going to have to drop soon. It's already halfway there. It's going to be the Reinhardt dropping down. Juggernaut is down there for UCLA, but that means Banana Bread is able to get into the back line. Good Zarya barrier keeping Raxa alive for now, and he's able to get healed up. Two picks coming out from UCLA here on the defense. They will thwart Berkeley.
That was some really good peel, to be honest. Like, you know, the Zarya bubble came out, saved Raxa after he was jumped on by the Doomfist. I don't think his rollout was necessarily the best, Banana Bread's, because he kind of got stopped by, you know, the upper edge of the roof. But you can see kind of what they're trying to do with this this Cal attack.
Yeah, bait down the tanks and then allow the dive to go in. It should be that much easier, but, you know, credit to Sereku for the side of UCLA, being able to stay back there, get his shield up in time to keep Raxa alive. You need to keep your DPS up now. Banana Bread on the high ground over at Water Coolers will make his way into the back line. And so even though they're not running that Reinhardt, they're still going to go ahead and try and get them off the point just by wrapping around. But UCLA, they're not budging.
I like this, actually, because this wraparound means that UCLA needs to be very careful in the sense that this Doomfist can just one-shot people if they decide to contest point. And look, oh, misses the one-shot on Raxa, but ends up killing him after the dragon comes out.
Yeah, and so that's a two-for-one exchange. Juggernaut's going to even that out for UCLA. It's still a fracas on the point as Seven is just cleaning up member after member with the help of Juggernaut here. UCLA is able to hold on to this point, but there's an EMP used by Cal, but it's going to be for nuts. There's no follow-up whatsoever. He will clean up Harukaze, will onto the Juggernaut, and so now there is a moment possibly for Cal to try to get in there, but UCLA, they're getting their reinforcements.
And it looks, this is very similar to what we saw against UCSD and UCI, where now we see Cal coming back in. The respawns were faster, and now it looks like they have control of the point.
Primal Rage out from Gulag. He's even got the nano boost as he's jumping onto the back line. He was slept for a second, but now he's getting stunned up. Two ticks gone, secured for Cal, as Gulag is not able to make his escape. Still, though, they are making progress on the point. R. Berkeley,
Sereku.
Raxa is back now.
Sereku unable to get the grav off, and now it looks like the hack on the Tracer, but Raxa is able to finish off the Sombra.
Yeah, and that's huge, right? Usually Sombra, if they're able to hack the Tracer, they're able to finish them off, but yeah, UCLA were able to get back in here in time and hold on, even though Gulag was doing a good job with that Primal Rage to keep them off the point. Eventually, once he does fall, UCLA, they were able to just collapse onto Cal. And so now there's 1 minute remaining. Cal, they've only secured two ticks here. They need one more. This is going to be basically the last fight on point A.
And if Cal wants to take this, I think Harukaze and Banana Bread need to take better opportunities when trying to get into the back line, because right now it feels like they're rushing it a little bit.
Yeah, the Sombra positioning has been a little awkward at this point. Banana Bread goes for that Rocket Punch, but there's nothing. There we go. Seismic Slam into the back, and he's able to connect on the Sang. It's a one-for-one exchange. Harukaze going down early again. Meteor Strike comes out now. Banana Bread right onto the point. Sound Barrier is there, but he's not able to connect with anything at all. It's going to be Raxa, actually, on the opposite end, taking out Tribal now. That's huge, getting rid of the support line, but Banana Bread keeps this fight in contention for him until Juggernaut takes him out.
Absolutely, and this Doomfist is getting so much done on this point where there's so many walls around. Harukaze is the last member left on the Tracer, and it looks like he has to run out.
He needs to survive. He needs to be able to touch the point. Now, they are going to be able to force out that recall. 3 seconds left. Harukaze is able to get overtime going for his team, but he gets slept. He gets taken out, and now it's the Doomfist trying to get on there. There we go. They've got the Lucio and Kaido Alter to be able to keep this point alive, but that means he's not healing Banana Bread, who will fall to Raxa now. Primal Rage used by Gulag once again. again, but great the Earth Shatter is there. Juggernaut has been an absolute one for his team, an immovable object. And that's going to be UCLA holding on to point A. Cal only securing 79.9%.
That's a really great hold. We saw it capped off with that sleep on the Tracer blinking around. You know, once UCLA was able to get back after a bit of an overcommit, I would say, with the Primal Rage in the backline, they were able to finally come back, take control of the point, and then force Cal off of it.
Yeah, again, we're seeing, you know, the kind of inexperience in these new rosters right now. Even though these four teams are supposed to be some of the best teams in the nation, to get to be the best, it takes time, it takes practice, and we're still in, like, the building block stages for a lot of these. This is a great opportunity for them to, first, A, you know, get LAN practice, but B, get practice at all right now. And so, it's going to be UCLA now on the attack, and 80% on point A. We've seen, you know, it's just one team fight, one, and that's basically it.
Yeah, absolutely. And I'm really excited to see what kind of comp they bring out. You know, they can opt for the GOAT, which is kind of like the, I would say, the easy way into it. But you saw that Doomfist that's being played by both teams. And, you know, you never know what's going to happen, when the Doomfist is able to get into your backline.
Yeah, Banana Bread, he was able to find some pickoffs, but really, as a Doomfist, it's not about getting that initial pickoff. It's about getting the second. It's about getting the third. The follow-ups with those rocket punches. There was a time where he I forget who it was. I think he was trying to get onto Roxa, who was on the Hanzo at that point. And he was mid-animation for his dragon. He still missed that rocket punch onto him. And that can't happen. You need to be able to finish them off. Roxa, though, he's going to be playing the Widowmaker here. And so, you know, since her changes, since her grapple cooldown changes a long time ago, she's been used quite frequently all sorts of places. And this is definitely one of the maps that she was used before those changes came out. So we'll see what he can do with it.
And I think this is very interesting because it's going to really limit Banana Bread's movement. He's not going to be wanting to play behind the shield, but now he's going to be forced to do so because of the Widowmaker sightlines.
Yep, Roxa having some difficulty trying to take out Tribal on the other end there, not able to connect with those shots. There we go. He's just kind of standing still.
There we go.
Finds the headshot, and that's a huge pickoff, taking out that Ana early.
And this May is a really big gamble, but it doesn't look like it's going to pay off, where now, finally, UCLA taking control of the point. It looks like they're going to win this fight.
And yeah, it looked like Harakaze was trying to channel some of that aligned energy onto this hold, but it's not going to be enough. Banana Bread does take out Roxa, but someone's contesting some point right now. It looked like it was Kaito Alter first hit coming in. Second will be secured by UCLA. And they need to make a last minute ditch effort. Oh. No! Banana Bread not able to get that rocket punch on. And that's going to be an early first map for UCLA in this best of three.
Yeah, and that was a very dominant victory, I would say. You know, Berkeley came in here the favorite. This is a team that's won TESPA twice. UCLA hasn't even been to the top four, right? Mm-hmm. And so to see them come out with such a dominant showing, I think it's very, I would say, you know, it looks good for this school.
Yeah.
Where they're building out this program.
It definitely looks good. And you mentioned it yourself, right? There wasn't as much support when you were leaving UCLA or when you were attending at the time. But now it's slowly but surely more schools in the nation are getting involved in esports. And, you know, it does look like the athletic program is behind them now. But again, Cal, these players, they have a huge legacy, like you had mentioned, to really live up to. Two-time national TESPA Collegiate Series champions. And really, both those times, they did it in a very dominant fashion. But they lost one of their biggest tools in Aligned. He was a standout DPS for them, but now, you know, he's moved on to try and do Contenders. He's been with Mayhem Academy, moved over to the main tank role, but losing a very crucial member, especially in a DPS role, and trying to fill that out, it's really just big shoes to really fill for Cal at this point. And, you know, do you think something like that kind of legacy kind of gets in your mind?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm sure they're all thinking about it. But what's really interesting to me is, do these guys have the mentality of the champions that they mm-hmm. once were? Because as a champion, you know, once adversity hits, you're going to be wanting to fight back. You're not going to give up. And that was a very tough match, I would say. You know, they weren't able to cap even the first point. So looking into this second match, or mm-hmm. map rather, we're going to want to see whether they can tap into, you know, that champion energy, you know, what they once were.
Yeah, they go plus ultra. We'll see. Again, though, you know, we didn't get to really see much. It was point A. It happened pretty quickly. teams do play a little bit differently when we go over to Control. So maybe there's going to be a bit more fight coming out from Cal at that point once we go over there. It looks like a lot of words being exchanged between the teams. They're still lighthearted, right? Because this is ultimately, while you know a lot of pride's on the line, it's still a lot of fun to be able to come and play LAN. I mean, that's one of the best things, right? That kind of LAN energy where you all just get to gather and like just banter and have fun instead.
Absolutely.
You know? This isn't the national finals quite yet. This isn't the Fiesta Bowl. This isn't the TESPA Championships. And so they understand where they're at. They want to have a good showing, but they also want to have fun because it's LAN.
As much as that is the case, I would definitely want to win for that California Cup, that little trophy that the colleges get to take home.
Yeah, honestly, at this point. But right now, it looks like we're just getting loaded onto the next map. It should be a Control map. I'm not entirely too sure which one it is. But UCLA, honestly, really did come out of, you know, the gate swinging at that point. It was a great hold coming out from them. There was one great moment, Gulag getting into the back with that Prime Ridge. But again, you had mentioned it was an overcommittal. He didn't have the quite exit that he wanted. And as a Prime Ridge Winston, you're holding on to that double leap to get out of the bad spots. And so that didn't quite happen for them. But it looks like it is going to be Lijiang Tower for the second map. And so teams are all back there. I forgot that someone had actually left for a moment. And so we're going to get into the second map. It is going to be, of course, this is best of three. So this is match point for UCLA. We'll see if we have another 2-0 and if they're going to be the ones to face off against UCI in our third match of the day.
And for me, I'm expecting to see a lot of hit scan out of Roxa from UCLA. He's the lone member that's been there throughout the entire time this team has existed. Mm-hmm. And I'm expecting to see the Widowmaker on, you know, Night Market on Garden. And I'm expecting to see McCree perhaps, maybe even a May on the Control Center.
Yeah, that was an odd pick, I want to say, on the defense. That May coming out.
Yeah.
What did you think of that? What do you think kind of like, let's theory craft here. What was the use of that May?
So we saw Doomfist and May, right? So maybe they thought they could do something with, you know, against a GOAT comp that they might expect.
Yeah.
You can isolate a tank and then use Doomfist to one-shot them or at least take them very low and then finish them off. But didn't seem like that worked out, especially against the hitscan, where once the main wall was down, Roxa was able to get picks.
Yeah, possibly. I mean, we even got to see, of course, like main Reinhardt. Now that we're actually loaded here on the Control Center, that was something that used to happen often. The May would go ahead and wall off, and the Reinhardt would charge and get a confirmed elimination onto someone. But yeah, that means we are on Lijiang Tower. We on Control Center. We should be seeing very heavy tank play coming out. The Rein Zarya's for both sides. We got Doomfist on both sides, but it's a projectile that are the difference. UCLA, Roxa is going to be running that Hanzo, while Cal on the other end, again, channeling that aligned energy. Harukaze is going to be on the May.
I think they're going to be at the advantage in this first fight. You see, they're already charging in. There's a big purple net on UCLA, but Seven's able to take up Banana Bread.
Yeah, it's a one-for-one exchange, though. So Sirico will fall as that Zarya, so the Reinhardt battle should go in favor of Cal at that point. Harukaze picks up Juggernaut there. Again, it's exchanging back and forth, but still in the favor of Cal right now. UCLA, Roxa doesn't have that Reinhardt, so it's difficult for him to go ahead and peek out. That's going to allow Cal to get the point first.
I think Hanzo's draw is going to be very hard here. He needs to be looking for flanks because when you have this Reinhardt, you have this Maywall in your face, you can't really do much with the Hanzo. So you're going to see he's walking around a lot, trying to get angles and see if he can get picks on the back line.
He's at 83%. He's getting damage, right? He is that tank buster,
Absolutely.
Especially with the Storm Arrows, but he needs to get the kills. He hasn't quite yet. But the Nano Boost comes out for both Reinhardt. It's going to be Gulag that gets it on top of Sang. Both Annas are down now. Rox is trying his best. There we go. Gulag once again overextending with that Reinhardt will fall. Now a 7 goes in with that Meteor Strike. Takes out Banana Bread. And so it's going to be the slow cleanup coming out from UCLA. But they will be able to get them off the point and flip it. Cal, get 37%.
Good fight out of UCLA. Now I'm really looking to see what they will do with that Dragon Strike. If they're going to wait for the Zarya Graviton Surge and combine those. You know, that's kind of considered a confirmed kill, but as we see right here, Roxa gets a pickoff on Tribal. They're going to have to wait, reset the fight. Syracuse edges closer to that Graviton.
Yeah, that's a great pickoff, right? You get the Ana. That's 15 seconds now, almost 15 percentage points that Cal have to wait it out. And so the respawns are in, but take a look at how close UCLA are playing. Ooh, 7 dropped real low there, but the Graviton Surge connects onto 3. Sound Barrier is used. Here comes the Dragon. It connects as Roxa takes out 4 with that, and Juggernaut cleans up 2. That's the whole clean team wipe coming out from UCLA.
Big play out of Roxa and Syracuse. We saw that coming from a mile away. They've been saving it up for this fight in particular. Now they're going to try and hold aggressively. We see the Reinhardt right here going for the early shatter.
Oh, you know, you're going to get the, of course, the Rocket Fist coming on in the hammer down and only connects onto one, but that allows him to clean up Jay. Seven will fall for his efforts there, but Stranger gets a double kill for himself on that Lucio now. And that wall off isn't enough to punish Juggernaut. They're going to clean up once more. UCLA now at 63%.
And this is some good holding by UCLA. They're holding at the gates. They're making sure that Cal can't get in for free. Now, there's a Graviton Surge that they need to be wary of because that can win the fight right there, especially without a defensive ult to help. Actually, rather, Stranger does have the Lucio.
The sound barrier, right? Yeah. But the thing is, they don't have this huge ultimate. They don't have a Graviton Surge, and it's going to be that Doomfist coming in, connecting with that Meteor Strike. The Sound Barrier was used by Stranger, so that saved them from that. But what about the rest of the damage coming out? Kaito Alter with a double kill on that Lucio now. And still, Cal, even though they've largely won this team fight, they need to clean up quickly, because right now, UCLA, they're at 96%.
We're seeing these Lucios frag a lot. Look at Kaito Alter gets another kill. And now finally, Cal's able to switch the point. But we see the ult coming out from UCLA, and they should be looking to make a strong impression in this next fight.
Yeah. Again, though, this is on a knife's edge at this point, 99 to 47% here. They can't make any mistakes at all. Harukaze, his walls need to be on point. It splits off two members. One of them's a Doomfist, one of them's a Zarya, and Sireku's able to just walk up. There it is, the combination. The sound barrier is not enough as Roxa cleans up two. Seven finds a third in Jay, and it's going to be all UCLA. Harukaze only answering by taking out Sireku, but as the point flips, no one's there to touch the point. Overtime ticks away. UCLA gets the first point here on Lijiang.
And they played their comp exactly like it needed to be played. You know, once they got control of that point, they held aggressively. They were able to make use of the combos between the Dragon Strike and the Graviton Surge. And, you know, good play to UCLA.
Yeah, the only time Cal was able to find that opening was when the Graviton along with the Earthshadow were gone. And that's when, of course, UCLA couldn't be as aggressive. And you saw them starting to fall back because they didn't have those two big tank ultimates. But once they did, they knew their win condition. They were able to secure upon it. And again, I understand, of course, that May pick. It just did not work for them, really. I didn't really see, like, the Blizzards coming out or anything used in conjunction with something like, of course, a Graviton. But now things are going to change completely because we are here on Garden. And so the Pharahs do come out, but it's going to be Roxa, actually, rocking the Widowmaker for UCLA.
I'm really interested to see what the Wrecking Ball rollout is here. He's going to try and get on the back line, presumably. And he's really close right now to them. Can just go for the grapple. And looks like he gets the Ana.
Yeah, he just swings on top of Tribal, takes her out now. She was the main support line for the ground army of Cal, while, of course, Kaito Alter is basically tethered to Banana Bread this whole time. Banana Bread wasn't able to do much at all because Roxa on that Widowmaker taps him early, and Banana Bread just backs away because he didn't want to get taken out early on. That meant that largely huge portion of Cal's DPS was just hiding and cowering behind.
And now control goes over to UCLA. Roxa looks for an aggressive angle, try and get picks on the back line while he controls the Sombra now coming out from Cal.
Yeah, those headshots, they do so much damage here. Juggernaut on the bridge, they're able to just get some good damage off. And
Kaito
Alter, yeah, split off from the rest of the team.
But it looks like he's able to get to safety. Now they're coming through white, trying to contest the point. Now look at this Wrecking Ball strategy. Yeah.
It's half troll, it's half actual legitimate strategy there. But ooh. Banana Bread right on top gets way too aggressive. Racks up with a good flick, takes him out. That's going to be three kills gone. Both supports gone for Cal. And so even though they were contesting the point, they don't have any presence whatsoever anymore. Harukaze still trying to build up this EMP as he had to make that swap off. But we have the Infrasight out. And so he might be using that stealth, but they know exactly where you are, buddy.
And I'm really liking Seven on this Doomfist. He's a new player to the team. Oh, big pick. Going to stall some more percentage. But Seven, a new player for this team, and he's really doing a lot of work to complement Roxa on the Widowmaker.
Yeah, honestly, as long as Roxa's got that space, he's had almost no pressure on him whatsoever on this Widowmaker. That one time where Banana Bread was able to get close to him with that Far was about the only time he was under pressure at all, and that is largely due to Juggernaut and Seven really going in as a dive buddy. EMP's on out, and Seven's caught in it, but it doesn't matter because Roxa just needs the left click, takes out Harukaze. Banana Bread does go for the barrage, but still a 2-for-2 exchange right now. Roxa keeping this alive for now, but slowly, surely, Cal is swinging this in their favor.
This is a really fragmented fight. We saw half the team go to the EMP targets. The other half went through white, went for the barrage on point. Now, finally, Cal is able to take control of the point, but it looks like UCLA has already managed to regroup while Seven comes back as a Doomfist. You know, going to be very fast to come back and roll out.
Yeah, but so much was committed by Cal just to try and take that point. Gulag, his Primal Rage is gone. The Self-Destruct is gone. They even used the Mercy Ultimate. And Harutokaze now has swapped off onto the Tracer, while UCLA in that last fight, they largely just lost it all. Roxa pops out in for sight, is able to find Harutokaze, takes him out early on. So it's a 6v5 on the point. Make that a 6v3 as Seven connects. Two man, Meteor Strike, and Roxa will be able to clean up for the team. Though that's going to be UCLA taking back control of the point. Cal have only a moment to get back onto the point.
And that's what I really like to see, the Space Jam combo, as we call it, with the Doomfist Meteor Strike on top of the Graviton Surge. But it looks like UCLA came in strong. They had some very good ultimate game planning, and they played really well to take out the two-time champions in Berkeley.
Yeah, and just like that, it is over. UCLA will take out Cal.